I'm assuming everybody here also watches Number File. Giuseppe, we're all watching Number Files?
Oh, yeah.
Number File is great. So just in case you don't watch Number File, you really should. And we've got it was one of our recommended channels up there. Now, recently, Number File posted a video just a couple of days ago about the very, very famous Kakeya needle problem. It was great as usual, but it got a bit technical in parts and quite a few people actually got lost. And so we had a challenge from some of our viewers who also watch Number File to see whether we could do it a little bit simpler and maybe even without any numbers, without any formulas. So here's our answer to this challenge, okay? So I'll take a slightly different approach from what people usually do, okay? I'm going to use a squeegee. I'm not going to use a needle. Okay, the squeegee starts out in this green position here, and then it ends in the blue position. And so you can go from the green position to the blue position in many, many different ways. Let's just do the most obvious one. So we kind of start around here, and then we just swipe across like that, okay? And so it swipes across area, because basically the area that gets cleaned, and we're interested in this area, okay? Now we can swipe in many, many different ways. Let's do it in a second way. So for example, we could swipe up there, and then we could swipe down there. That gives us a different area, right? And now, obviously, we can go really, really wild by kind of swiping like this before we kind of get to blue, and that will get like more and more area. But now it comes a slightly strange question. What's the minimal area we can create like this? Right? So I mean, how can we get from left to right and create a minimal wiping area? Okay, and it might seem that, well, I mean, there was the square at the beginning and there's this arrow here. They're actually the same area.
Oh, they are?
Yeah, they are.
Oh, this one looks a little bit bigger.
Well, it isn't. Well, anyway, maybe the guys can sort it out in the comments again. Why are these two areas the same? Okay, now it turns out that you can actually make it a lot smaller than this. And I'll just show you what the trick is. So what you do is these two line segments are parallel, and actually the squeegee is a mathematical line segment. So it doesn't have any width for this sort of setup here. And then what we do is we kind of just extend the green line and the blue line. And the first move we do is we just kind of move it along this line. And since it doesn't have any width, it's actually not wiping out any area, okay? So far we've not wiped anything. And now we aim from this point up here to that point down there. And now we wipe like that, okay? And now we just move along this line, so no extra area created. And then we wipe again. And then we just move where we want to go. Finished, right? Now we just compare the wiped area to what we had before, to this one here. And you can see it's
smaller.
It's smaller, smaller. And actually we can make it even smaller. Can you imagine, how can we make it even smaller? Giuseppe hasn't actually seen this before. So just think about it, okay, how can we make this even smaller?
So we just go way up there. The higher we go, the smaller that angle will be.
That's right. So the first move, you just go higher up, okay? So you just go higher up, and then these angles will get smaller. Actually, it's pretty obvious that these two angles are always going to be the same, right? Mm-hmm. And so, you know, they simultaneously get smaller. Okay, and then now if I push it really high up, you know, you basically can make this as small as you want. So if you give me any positive number, as small as you want, I can make the wiping area that number, basically.
So how come we can get zero?
Well, because we really have to get from left to right, and to get from left to right, we have to angle this thing at some point in time. As soon as you angle it, it's going to be positive area. Doesn't matter how far up we go. Right? Okay, so that's kind of just a warm-up exercise, okay? And so why did this work? Why does this kind of counterintuitive thing come up? Well, mainly because the initial position, the last position, they're parallel, right? So then we can kind of go up, and then with minimal swipe, we can kind of bring this into the second position. So what happens now if we make the second position here, like not parallel to the first one, like this, right? Or like that, or whatever, then we also can swipe from here to there. What's the answer then? How small can we make things? And actually, we're just going to go kind of for the worst possible scenario, where we kind of have this as the initial position, and as the final position, we kind of have the whole thing kind of turned 180 degrees. So what we're requiring here is that during the motion, we are going through 180 degrees before we can come back to what we started with, okay? And that's basically the Kakeya needle problem. It asks if we want to do this, what's the smallest area we can create? Okay. Okay. And the answer is also pretty surprising, but let's just see how anybody off, taken off the street, like an expert in this, would solve the problem of turning like from here to there. Okay. So, I mean, I think what everybody would be doing is kind of try something like this. Right? So we just kind of just go in a circle, and with an area that's swept out like this, can we do any better than this? What do you think, Giuseppe? Can we do any better than this? Well, obviously, because I set it up like that.
Yeah, I mean, this is what I would do, but yeah. There's definitely a better way.
There's definitely a better way. So here's a nice one. So we just start with our line segment like that. Then we swipe like 30 degrees. And we swipe like that. And we swipe like that. And we swipe like that. And basically what we've done now is we've swept out an equilateral triangle whose height is the length of the squeegee. And actually, we're going to make the length of the squeegee 1 centimeter, 1 meter, whatever, 1 unit of something, okay? There, 1. And now we can actually compare the areas of those two guys. And so the area of that one here is 0.7 something, and the area of this one here is 0.57. So it's actually a lot better. And for some setup, this is actually the best. So if you've got like aiming for an area that's swept that doesn't have any kind of indentation or is like, you know, then this one's actually the best. But if you're a little bit more relaxed about what you can do, there's actually better ways of doing this. And the problem is like 100 years old. And even then they came up with something better. And I'll show you what they came up with. So what you start out with here is a big circle. And inside the big circle is a small circle. It's the small circle is 1/3 of the diameter of the big one. And I will just roll this guy here. And so a point on the boundary traces out this curve. And if you just scale things right, we get this figure. So the our one segment just fits in like that. And now we can turn it around in here. And it's actually quite an amazing movement. You can see like at any point throughout the movement, we've got that end bit here touching the boundary of the curve, this one here and that one. So there's 3 points that are really on the boundary. It's a very, very tight fit. It's something really, really quite miraculous by itself. So that shape is called a deltoid. And so how small is that one now? Well, quite a bit smaller than this guy. No?
So at any part of the moving that segment, it's touching all three sides?
Yep. Wow. So it's touching all three sides. So it's pretty good. Yeah. Okay, now, well, the thing is, you know, it's 100 years old. At some point in time, they actually figured out we can do even better. We can do significantly better. And here's what we do. So we'll start out with the same triangle that we'll just use to kind of swipe things out, okay? And now we'll cut this into little triangles. So the bases of all those little triangles are the same widths, right? And we'll cut it apart like this and overlap those little triangles and overlap more, okay? So now we've gone from an equilateral triangle to a shape that's got an area that's a lot less, right? And actually, if you use more triangles and are really smart about this pushing together, we can actually make the area of this shape as small as we want. That's pretty surprising. It's actually pretty tricky to prove too, but it's true. So, you know, chop it up into maybe a gazillion little triangles and, you know, push them together in just the right way. And actually getting pretty close to zero with the total area. Okay, and now I'm going to show you how you can turn the needle around in something like this. So we've got this little tree here and we've got the initial triangle, okay? And now what we're going to do is let's just focus on the two little triangles on the left, okay? And I'm going to highlight them here in purple and in brown. And I'm also highlighting the common, you know, edge, okay? So in yellow. And now where are these two guys here in the tree? Well, the brown triangle is here and the blue triangle is there. And obviously those two yellow lines, are they parallel or not?
Yeah, they're parallel.
They're parallel, obviously, right? Okay. That's going to be important for later, okay? Okay, now we're going to start turning our needle in here, okay? Or our squeegee. So for me, the squeegee for, you know, the usual setup, it's a needle that's being turned in the plane. Okay, so there it is, the squeegee, and we're turning it, no problem, both on the left and on the right. Now, obviously, here we're stuck, right? There's actually no way you can turn this thing further in just inside the figure. But now we remember the trick the magic move that we designed at the very beginning, right? And we've got these two parallel lines. So what we'll do is exactly there, right? Remember that? All right, and come back, and now we can turn, right? So that works. And well, I mean, there's these little wedges that also get swept out here, but what you really have to imagine is that we're going a lot further out, right? So basically, I said we can push this to kind of close to zero, so we cannot just forget about it for whatever comes next, okay?
So that swiping becomes negligible.
Becomes negligible, okay? So now we just keep on going, right? Putting in a lot more of those connections and just kind of keep repeating this trick over and over, and you can see that we're succeeding in slowly turning the squeegee through 60 degrees, right? So almost there. And just the last wipe, and we've wiped 60 degrees, okay? So we've wiped 60 degrees. Okay, well, we've 60 degrees, but we need 180. So what do we do next? Well, we bring a second tree in, okay? So a second tree like this, just turn 60 degrees, and then we make a transfer using the same kind of magic move, right? And again, imagine that this is really pushed out forever, right? And coming back, and we're starting our second 60 degrees. And we just keep on going like this, and we get 120, and then we need a third tree. And I'm just to see what the whole figure here looks like. So that's the whole thing, you know, let's arrange it like this, and we get this nice fish-like thing. And now I'm just going to show you how the whole 180 works. So that's the starting position. We want to get back to that at the end, but, you know, we want to have turned 180 degrees. So now we go all this complicated movement that gets us to there. Then we make the transfer, right? And we get another complicated movement, another transfer, and another complicated movement gets us here. And then we can just push up and we're back to where we started from. So pretty cool, right? And now what does this say? Well, what I said is that if we kind of cut up the triangle at the beginning into lots and lots of pieces, we can make this overlapping tree as small as we want. That means we can make the three trees as small as we want. And by pushing out like these transfers, you know, really, really far, we can make everything inside here as small as we want. So you give me any positive number, doesn't matter how small it is, I can arrange this whole setup here so that the total area swept by our squeegee throughout the movement is smack on this number or less.
Yeah. So the number of trees will still be three, but then what increases as we're getting smaller and smaller is the number of branches.
The number of branches, that's right. Yeah. So that's basically one branch, or well, one tip per little triangle that we're using, right?
Yeah.
So there's going to be a lot more tips, a lot more of these like kind of lines starting out, and also kind of the path that you're, or the distance that you're covering throughout that your journey here is going to be, you know, ridiculous. And so that's basically all there is, right?
And if we want to do a full circle, then we just add two more trees?
No, we just kind of repeat the whole thing in here, because we've done 180 degrees, and then we just kind of go for a second round and we get 360 degrees.
Right? That's the maximum amount of trees that we would need.
Yeah, so for this one here, it's fine, right? And we could even do like, we could start off the like a 90 degree triangle, and then we just need two, basically. That's also doable. Now, why did the number files video turn out a little bit technical? Well, the guy who's explaining it, I mean, he's actually in the genius category, right? So he's like a Fields medalist, like really, really serious stuff, basically equivalent of a Nobel Prize winner in maths. And he's actually interested in these sorts of things. I mean, it might seem like a pretty trivial problem, you know, it's cute, but I mean, what does it have all to do with real maths? Well, it's kind of the starting point for some really, really, really deep stuff that actually quite a few of these Fields medalists are interested in. And I'm going to provide some links down here at the bottom to some survey articles by Terry Tao, an Australian Fields medalist, who talks about this stuff. And you can just have a look at it and kind of get a feel for what's going on. And so there were two things that made the number files video complicated. What the guy was trying to do was actually get you a little bit closer to the deep end, right? By really giving you a good idea of why we can make these things arbitrarily small. I was skipping over that, right? So he was giving quite a bit of detail there, why you can make the trees really arbitrarily small. But also, he talked a lot more about how exactly you're going to push them together. And that's very important for later on. So basically we can subdivide into, you know, 4 triangles, 8 triangles, 16 triangles, maybe doubling up every time. And then we can make up these trees. Now, the deep people, they're interested in making up the trees so they're kind of connected. They're making a sequence of trees that kind of converges to something. And in the limit, this something has very interesting properties. So what it has is it has area zero. So we are just getting close to zero. But this thing they're really interested in has area zero. Wow. And also, what it still has is basically like a line segment of unit length in every single direction, right? So I mean, as we turn around, we kind of see like the individual moments that just kind of moves. You can see like one line segment pointing this way, one line segment pointing this way, one line side. So in all possible directions, we've got line segments here in our constructions, but the total area is still positive. So what they're getting there is something that has zero area and still has all line segments in all possible directions. And with that sort of stuff, you can then do some really amazing things. And just in general, you want to ask anything about this or anything about the number files video, you know, just feel free, post in the comments. I'm happy to answer all these things. And so now to finish off, I mean, this gives me a really, really good idea. I mean, I just brought in the pumpkin pie because it's Halloween in a couple of days' time. But of course, I mean, what I really am going to do now is I'm going to do a t-shirt of my Kakeya fish. And that's it for today.